On today's Committee to Wednesday, let's break down a subscriber's M91 build. The M91 since the beginning of the Warzone has always been a pretty decent weapon. Nothing special, but nothing really bad either. And it really hasn't been buffed or nerfed since the beginning. And actually, when I first started playing, this was my favorite weapon. But after all the new weapons we have, how does it compare to them all? So in his build, he has a monolithic suppressor, the M91 heavy barrel, the TAC laser, scout combat optic, and sleight of hand. This is extremely close to what I have, and it's going to be making comparisons very easy. So let's take a look at its stats, starting with mobility. It has an ADS time of 430 milliseconds, which is kind of expected for LMG, but still, this is not that great. Its reload and reload add times are 5.75 seconds from empty and 4.9 if you leave one in the mag, which is pretty good for a 100 round mag. Its movement and sprint speeds are slightly above average for an LMG, but still, nothing really special. But its ADS strafe speed is right on what an LMG would be getting. Its sprint out and attack sprint out times are slightly above average again of what an LMG would get, but still below average for every other weapon. Its aiming stability is 2T, which is pretty okay for long range, and its bullet velocity is an average 909.1 meters per second, which isn't the greatest for long range, but it is doable. And lastly, its rate of fire is 11.1 rounds per second, or 666 rounds per minute, so it gets a mobility score of 23. Its recoil is interesting. Overall, it has a pretty high vertical magnitude, but for the first 30 shots, it's comparable to almost a PKM. But after the first 30 shots, the recoil pattern just expands. It also has a lot of side-to-side bouncing, which makes it harder to use at longer ranges. And its visual recoil is quite a lot. Because of all these factors, you can only use this reliably while standing up to 100 meters. So it gets a recoil score of 40. Now for its damage. It has a drop-off at 39 meters. In the first damage range, its headshot TTK isn't the greatest, but its upper torso, lower torso, and limb TTKs are all average. Remember, you still have an open bolt delay, but if you fire first, there's a good chance that you're going to be winning as long as you're not fighting something like a meta SMG. And especially between 25 and 40 meters, if you're hitting all your shots, you're going to be winning a lot of gunfights. In the second damage range, it gets better. Its headshot and upper torso TTKs are now above average, and its lower torso and limb TTKs are still average, which is great. And as long as you get one headshot in the mix, you're going to be able to keep that great above average TTK, even if you're only hitting limb shots. But technically, yes, you can get even better TTKs in both ranges. If you hit one headshot and four upper torso shots, you can now get a 501 millisecond TTK. However, this is going to be way too precise for most people, and you're probably going to be better off just going for headshots. And in the second damage range, one headshot with all the rest of the shots being upper torso shots would also get you an insane TTK, which you're definitely not going to be getting, especially with the recoil this weapon has. You'll be getting pretty good TTKs without this, so just use the weapon normally. So it gets a damage score of 60, and when we add up all the categories, it gets a final score of 123. This is a pretty good score for a weapon. It's pretty balanced, and yeah, it's not going to be meta, but it's still decent. Sure, the EM2, MG82, C58, and even the PKM will be winning a lot against this weapon, but if you want to play off meta, this is actually an okay choice. However, I did want to compare it to my optimized build. Now, the difference in our builds is that I don't use the heavy barrel. I would rather have better ADS and movement speeds and no recoil control help, while also getting a benefit of better bullet velocity. I also use the VLK since I'm on PC, but if you're on console, I would recommend that you use the Canted Hybrid for slightly better recoil control. And instead of Sleight of Hand, while Sleight of Hand is a great option, I use the ADS stock. And here are the stats compared to each other. The first thing you notice is that it now has an ADS time of 350, which is huge. 350 is the ADS time for LMGs that we want to get to with open bolt delays. But then you can also see that the reload and reload add times are basically 2 seconds slower. But if you ever run an LMG, you know pretty much not to run one in solos. Always run one with a squad, and make sure that they're covering you when you're reloading. Also, there's a little secret. You can kind of reload cancel and save a few seconds sometimes. My build gets a score of 24 for its mobility, so only 1 point more. But now, how's the recoil now that I've lost the heavy barrel? And here it is. It's pretty much the same. Essentially, the recoil gets stretched out a bit more, and in my opinion, this kind of makes it easier since you lose some of that side-to-side bounce. However, it still has the same visual recoil, and it's still just as hard to control. So I still only recommend that you use this up to 100 meters. And its damage is pretty much the same, just subtract 2 milliseconds from the TTKs of the heavy barrel build. And I'll say the same thing about this build that I said about the other. It's a decent off-meta build. However, due to the better ADS time, this one probably is going to feel a bit better when you're fighting back at closer ranges. It'll actually feel like you're standing a chance. Spool velocity may not be the biggest difference, and the recoil is going to be negligible as well. However, the one thing you will feel is the reload time. And yeah, 2 seconds is a big deal. When you're getting into a gunfight, it's probably going to be a lot better to be aiming down almost 100 milliseconds faster than it would be to be able to reload after the fight. And those 80 milliseconds could definitely be the difference between winning and losing, especially when fighting people with meta weapons. But once again, you should definitely be using this in a squad. Even as a solo, I wouldn't be using the MG82, despite its amazing TTK, because I don't want to be caught reloading in a long animation. So those were 2 M91 builds. Have you used it recently, and are you surprised by how good they actually are? But as always, if there's any weapon build or part of the game you want to break down, let me know. You may see it on the next Community Wednesday. But that's the video. If you enjoyed it or it's helped you in any way, let me know by leaving a like. If you got any questions or comments, leave them down in the comment section down below. And if you want to make sure that you never miss another video, be sure to subscribe. Thanks for watching.